Hello there, everybody. How's it going? It's Jessie from Jessie Marie Does Stuff here on FlossTube, coming to you on this Saturday, December 11th, 2021, with finally another Flossmas. Got to play catch up today. So real quick here, thank you all so much for your patience while I was absent. Hopefully it gave you a chance to catch up on some other Flossmas. I had a terrible migraine. I told you guys that I was taking Tuesday off, and that afternoon I had like 50% of my vision went gone. It was bad. It was a bad migraine. And then just getting back to film has been complicated with the aftershocks of a bad migraine. So we are here today, and I got my hair redone yesterday. I was going to try to film yesterday, but I didn't get out of there until 3, so I didn't get home until 3:30, and then by that point, it's dark out. I was exhausted, so yeah, didn't film yesterday. So, back to a much darker shade. I have to tell you this quick story about my hair. So, I started going to a new salon at the end of August when I first went dark, and I liked the stylist that I got. I liked her quite a bit, but they called me about a week and a half ago and said that she left. She went to start her own salon, so congrats to her. So I liked her, but she was passionate about blonde, and obviously I was not going blonde. So I was kind of excited to get somebody new who didn't specialize in blonding. I was assigned, so to speak, to a new stylist, and they called me a few days ago and said, she's out sick. Okay. And I guess COVID contact tracing, whatever. So I feel like I did this bounce around, but they were able to get me in yesterday anyway with another new stylist. And she's actually at the master level. So this salon has different levels, and she's at the master stylist level. And I really, really like her. So hopefully she sticks around for a little while so I can try to establish some sort of relationship. But anyway, so that was the hair saga. I was a little nervous going in yesterday because my original stylist, she knew the formula of the color that I wanted, and we had to start over. And she pulled the color based on a picture. It's not as purple as I was getting done. However, it seems to have stayed a little bit better than it did with Brittany. She, when I took a shower after Brittany did it, there was purple all over the towel, and I got to that sort of reddier color, and I didn't have a whole lot of purple today. A little bit because of where the dye, kind of hung out on my skin. But anyway, that's my hair story. But this isn't a hair channel. This is a cross-stitch channel. So let's get on with Flossmas. So much to talk about. I have the stitching that I have done over the last few days. I got a piece of haul in the mail that I would like to show you, an update on my knit. I am going to talk very briefly about my plans for the rest of December here. And then I think tomorrow I'm going to talk somewhat about my plans for 2022. And then it will just be regular Flossmas from there on out. Then I think we'll be all caught up for the most part. And then I have so much Advent to open. It's not even funny. I'm so excited. It's going to feel like Christmas morning because I think I have 5 of each to open. So much fun. And I've also not been spoiled, which I think is remarkable. So shout out to anybody who's doing the same Advents and putting up your spoiler alert images on Instagram and whatnot. Thank you very much for that. So I'm not spoiled by all of the goodies. So lots to get to. So let's get started with the stitching that I have done over the last few days. When I last saw you, or when you last saw me, I guess, I was working on November Quilt by Paula, Vaughan. So this is what this will look like finished. And this was one of my Whip Go draws for December. It's also my zombie run piece. So I wanted to be sure to get at least 400 stitches in or 5 days. And I managed to get 1,500 stitches in total. So zombie run, check. Whip Go goal, check. And as soon as I'm done showing this, I'm going to show you my Whip Go board as it stands currently. But here's where I got to. And I did a little bit more beyond what I showed on Instagram on Thursday. Yes, Thursday. I ended up working on this yesterday morning because I always do this. If I don't change out my project the night before, then I just end up stitching on whatever's on my frame when I get up in the morning. And that was the case with this. I forgot to switch my project out the night before. So when I got up Friday morning, I was like, well, I guess I'll work on this a little bit. So that is where I got to. Oh, folding the fabric means that you can see what I did on Friday. So the quilt is done. The quilt is all done. And, I mean, except for the extensive backstitch that needs doing, but the quilt is stitched, and then I worked on this wagon wheel. This wagon wheel is done, as well as this one that's kind of in the background. That's done. And then I decided to work my way across the left page, the left-hand page, to get the sky foundation in so that the next time that I work on this in the new year, I can just get going on the wagon up here. So let me show you on here. The sky is very hard to see, but I mean, that's kind of the point. The focus is supposed to be on everything else. So this sky bit is what I have worked on, what I worked on Friday. So yeah, I am so excited about this progress, not just for this rotation, because I mean, I had a migraine in there, but for the whole year. I've been toying with the idea of maybe doing a cross-stitch superlatives at the end of the year, like most likely to be finished next year and most likely to see the garbage bin. And this one keeps coming up as potentially most improved. Maybe I'll insert those pictures in my before and afters. I'm going to insert my at the start of the year and where I am now, and also what I did for this rotation. Because this one moved quite a bit. August quilt moved a lot more, but this one moved quite a bit. I did about 3,000 stitches this year on this one, and I'm up to 7,500 on August quilt. So maybe August quilt is my most improved. Anyway, I love this. So much fun. I love all those quarter stitches. Oh, so good. Fabric is a 32 count Belfast in cream from Zweigart, and this one's fairly little, so I think I can probably get another one on the other side of this fabric. Which reminds me, I have UFO'd July quilt, because that one was on a 28 count antique white linen, and originally I was okay with them all being on different fabrics, but I have come up with a plan for how I want to FFO them, fully finish them. And I would very much like them all to be on the same color of fabric. They're all different sizes, but I would like them to be on a similar color fabric, and I just love cream. So that is November quilt. Okay, so the basis for my plan for here in December is I have a wheel, and it's kind of more categorical that leads into other wheels and whatnot. So I had Danny spin my wheel, and he pulled Christmas Whip, And then he spun my Christmas whip wheel. And that's how we landed on this project here. This is Heap on the Wood by Brenda Gervais. This was a mania start 2020, and I hadn't worked on it since. So it was pretty cool to pull this out and work on a very little bit yesterday and a little bit this morning. And hopefully I can get some good progress over the next couple of days on this one. So, Heap on the Wood. This I haven't shown on Instagram yet, so that's kind of fun to be able to show you guys something that Instagram hasn't seen yet. And so this is on my big frame because it's a fairly large pattern. It's a wide pattern. This is a 32 count Belfast in Vintage Maple Sugar by Lakeside Linens. It's a beautiful warm fabric. I adore it. And so when I started this in Mania, I got probably 60 to 75% of the house complete. So yesterday and this morning, I finished up the house and I'm working on filling in the windows at this point. And then I think my plan for these couple of days is to work on some trees, maybe work my way this way. These cardinals here are 1/1. Maybe I'll work this border some too, this little inner border. Maybe the flower pot there. Maybe. I don't know. We'll see. I'll let you know what direction I go. So this is charted in a mix of things. Gentle Arts, Classic Color Works, Weeks Dye Works, DMC, the gamut. As is the Brenda Gervais way. And I did almost a complete overhaul of the threads. I think it's only the DMCs that I left the same. So that's the plan for Heap on the Wood, and I'm just loving it. So that's kind of what I have been working on. All right, so real quick, let's talk about my plans for December. Like I said, I've got wheels. And at this point, here on the 11th, we only have a couple of weeks left, which is bananas. But anyway, so I have three other Christmas whips. I have Christmas Quaker Bell Pull. I have Merry and Bright by Cottage Garden Samplings. And I have Farmhouse Christmas by Little House Needleworks that I have three blocks done and six not yet started. So those might come up. I need to get to my other two Zombie Run pieces before the end of the month. That's Glory of Autumn and August Quilt for at least 400 stitches each. We'll see. I'd really like to get a little bit further than that, but we'll see. You saw my whip go board earlier. I have two Glory of Autumn blocks. So if I could get 1500 stitches, I could get one more of those blocks done. And then, I don't know, maybe get another whip go. Let's see. What else do I have in there? I have focus on a finish, but I think that I'm probably going to ignore that. I'm probably not going to get any more finishes this year, which is okay. On Monday is the 13th, and so I will be pulling out my Kindred Spirits by the Primitive Needle and putting in a couple of days on that because I'd like to work on that for Dark 13 stitching. And I have November's section to catch up on, so that I will work on starting on Monday. I also have two more new starts planned for this month and for this year, one of which I am hoping is going to get here in time. It is The Fox, the Cottage Garden Samplings, A Year in the Woods, piece number one. Head over heels in love with that. I can already tell I'm going to love that whole series. And The Fox is just, it's stunning. I am on an auto ship with Top Knot Stitcher, and so I'm hoping that gets here before the new year. I'm starting it immediately. I am trying to sort out my fabric situation before that happens, but as soon as it gets here, start immediately. Doesn't matter. I have one other new start, and I think it's going to be Stitch Rovia's Be Kind. This was a lovely gift from Mandy, and it's my sign. So I will be probably starting this. I'm trying to stay under 13, or excuse me, a 13 or under new starts each year. And so this will be lucky number 13, because the fox is getting started. If it gets here, we'll see. So that is kind of my plan for December. But you'll see it as we go along. Okay, let's, I have just one piece of haul that I'd like to show you. I got a new project bag, and I got this from Stitch and Button, Vic Gable. She's here on FlossTube as Stitch and Button, and she has a Facebook group where she makes project bags and needle minders and all sorts of stitchy swag. It will definitely be linked in the description box below, but this is the project bag that I picked up. I'm in the mood for some wintery bags, and she posted this, and I thought it was just too cute. Too cute. And the pretty snowflakes on the inside. And then she sent along this button needle minder with like spools of thread on it. So cute. Thank you, Vic. And we'll just chalk that up to a WIPGO reward, because I got a couple of WIPGOs, as you saw. Okay, let's talk about my knit. I couldn't stitch a whole lot this week, and so I did some more knitting. And I am ahead of the game on my knit. I have 2.5 rows and a bind off left to do. So yeah, we're getting to the end here. So let me show this to you. And I foolishly barely started the next row, but didn't finish it. So it's gonna be a little awkward. So I am finished with the lace section. So let me see if I can open this up and show you. Yeah. So that lace section is now finished. Super, super pretty. I don't think I had enough yarn to do another repeat of the lace, so I'm really glad that I stopped. And then I have just a little bit of stockinette in this color here. It's supposed to be in the blue gray, but I decided that the pink was hardly used. It's just for this one section. So I decided to put the pink here at the end. It's bookended the lace, which is okay. I'm cool with that. So I have the rest of this purl row, one more knit, one more purl row, and then a picot bind off. So this isn't going to be finished anytime soon. Like, I'm not going to be able to finish it today, but it's coming down. We're getting close here. Getting close. So, just a quick reminder of the yarns, which are listed in the description box below. But the pink and the bluey gray are both Plucky Knitter Primo Fingering in the colorways CC Bloom and Poet's Corner. And they were part of a classics subscription from a number of years ago. And then the white, their creamy color, is Crying Dove from Dream and Color in their Smooshy with Cashmere base. So a bunch of MCN for this. And the shawl is called the three-color cashmere shawl, and it's designed by Joji Locatelli. Let's get to some advents. Because of my migraine this week, I have not had any tea. So I still have days 4, 5, 6, and now 7 through 11 to catch up on. Lots of tea in my future. I think probably a couple more days, and then I'll start chugging some tea to try to get through some of these. So let's get some tea advent opened. All right, so this is the 24 Days of Tea from David's Tea, and I need days 7 through 11. Oh boy, here we go. All right, we're not going to smell-o-vision all of these because it's too much. Day seven is an organic Japanese sencha. Looks like a green tea. Okay, day eight, we have, oh, it's got some fun stuff in there. Roasted chestnut. Oh, I bet that's good. Roasted chestnut. I'm not going to read what's in these. I'll talk more about them when I drink them. Maybe we'll go a little bit more vlog style for the teas, and I'll insert that as we go. Okay, this one's crazy. This is Buddha's blend. And it looks like there's a whole flower bud in there. Or garlic clove. So that'll be interesting. That was day 9. Day 10 is Fireside Mocha. So chocolate tea again. With some, I don't know if you can see them too well. But there's some, there we go. Some Christmas trees. Probably some sugar trees. Okay, and day 11. Day 11 is Organic Peppermint Amour. Okay. I'm about to say something controversial here. I hate peppermint. peppermint bark, doesn't do it for me. Yeah, I don't like York peppermints. I don't like peppermint. So we'll see how this goes. I'm still going to try it, but this may not be a favorite. We'll see. So those are the tea advents, and yeah, I got some tea to be drinking. So maybe we'll do some more vlog style as I go through those. Okay, let's get to Patchwork Rabbit. And I'm just going to go clip all those down and bring them over. Okay, 7 through 11, here we go. Day 7. Apologies if you've watched Mama Loves You, GB Michelle, because she's already shown these. But we have Classic Colorworks Wavy Navy. Beautiful blue. Day 8. I hope you can hear my kid laughing in the back. She's playing with Daddy right now. Oh, I love this color. Gentle Arts Rose Garden. Very beautiful. Day 9. I am loving watching you all open your advents. There's just so much cool stuff. Yikes. TMC light effects in E3852. Yikes. Maybe tinsel for my Christmas tree. that stuff is really hard to use. Okay, here's day 10. Week's Dye Works in Holly. Beautiful dark green. And day 11. Looks like a bunch of thread today, which I am not mad at. Ooh, another gorgeous Classic Colorworks in Khaki Mocha. Pretty, pretty. Love this. So let me just gather all of these up. Oh, very Christmassy. Very Christmassy. Look at that. All of those were for the last 5 days. All right, so we are all caught up. Showed you what I've been stitching on, opened some advents, so much fun. I think that's it for me today. So I'm going to head off here. Everybody, happy stitching. I will see you tomorrow for Flossmas Day 12. As always, be kind. See ya.